Hey, what is going on, people? Welcome to another installment of Tony's Take. All right, so interesting news coming out of the Microsoft camp today, which I needed to talk about because I want to get my thoughts out there and I obviously want to get a conversation going with you guys, right? So over at Major Nelson's blog, he posted that starting on March 20th, Xbox Game Pass, which you know is pretty much like a all-you-could-eat service from Microsoft, is going to be getting Xbox-exclusive games on the day they launch, right? March 20th is also the launch day of Sea of Thieves, right? So, yeah, basically, you know, for you who don't know, Xbox Game Pass for $9.99 a month, you get access to over 100 games, whether they be exclusives. I believe they have some third-party games in there. And what's cool about it is, unlike PlayStation Now, you could download the games to your system. You don't have to just play them streaming, which is great, you know. As a matter of fact, I've said, and it is on record too, that Xbox Game Pass is a better service than PlayStation Now, because PlayStation Now is nothing but streaming. Not really down with that. This right here, I don't know, man. Like, I'm going to talk about both sides, right? Because when I heard that you're going to have new games on the system or available on the service on day one, and maybe the first thing that came to my mind was like, isn't that going to hurt individual sales? Think about it, right? If you opt into the program, why would you need to buy an exclusive game from Microsoft anymore? They're going to be right there on Xbox, you know, Game Pass day one. So I'm like, I don't know, this seems like a weird move, right? And also on top of that, they also announced that at places like GameStop, for $59.99, you'll get 6 month subscription, right? So essentially for $120, the price of two individual games, you can get all of these games, right? All, you know, everything on Xbox Game Pass and all their exclusives. So I'm like, why would you have any incentive to buy an individual game? Like, let's say when Sea of Thieves drops, right? Why would you spend $60 on that game when you could spend $60 on the service along with all the other games, right? So it seems to me that they're hurting themselves in that regard, right? But at the same time, it could also be a really good way for them to generate revenue. Think about it like this, right? Okay, they may lose out on the individual game sales, but if more people opt into the program, that'll boost their revenue, which could offset whatever money they may lose from individual game sales, right? So certainly, it's a risk and reward type of thing, right? They're taking a big risk by essentially cutting off the legs of their games at launch, but they can make the money back on the back end by having the service, by having more people opt into it. So it's a very interesting thing. It depends on how you see the situation, right? I know, I'm looking at Twitter, obviously, some guys are saying that this is, you know, Microsoft is really shooting themselves in the foot with this, right? They're saying, you know, they're messing up big time. Other guys are saying this is a great move and it's going to help the Xbox division. So it really depends on how you see this, right? I think it's a risky move. I can't really say if it's going to hurt them in the long run, but I see the potential. But it could also really help them, you know? It's a weird thing. I can't really take a stance on this because I don't know how it's going to work. So yeah, I don't really know where to, you know, take this, but it could definitely help out Microsoft, right? Will I be opting into Game Pass? Not really, to be honest. I personally don't see the need for it. For me, I don't really play Xbox like that. I have an Xbox, but, you know, I don't know. I'd rather just get the games individually, even though I'm not exactly interested in Sea of Thieves. Actually, what do they have coming this year? Sea of Thieves, Crackdown 3, State of Decay 2. Me, personally, not really interested in any of them, but I know some of you guys are. So I want to know what you guys think about this. Do you think Xbox Game Pass is a good idea? Or do you think it's a bad idea? Well, it hurt Microsoft, right? Please let me know in the comments below. You know we're going to be talking about this on Throwdown on Thursday, man. So get ready for that. All right, that's it for this Tony's Take. A little short one for you guys. I'll see you next time. Later.